How big of a challenge is this?
I think it's monumental.
Delrish Moss is now the chief of one of the most scrutinized police departments in America, Ferguson PD. He left Miami Police to become the first African-American ever to be sworn in as chief here. Not a surprise move after the racially charged incident that shook this city to its core.
What made you take on this job?
The unrest on television, all those things. I saw it as a, you know, I hearkened back to good old days, and it wasn't that. I saw people hurting just like we hurt in Miami many years ago, and I said, you know what? I think I can help them.
He is Darren Wilson.
It's been more than a year since the resignation of the chief who was at the helm when white officer Darren Wilson shot and killed unarmed teenager Michael Brown after the two tussled in Wilson's police vehicle. The incident set off huge protests and sent shockwaves across the country, first when police used military-style equipment to try and control it, and then when riots broke out, burning parts of the city down. Chief Moss wasn't there for any of it, but when riots raged in Miami in the 1980s, he was there.
What about your background makes you uniquely qualified for this job?
One, from being a kid living in a riot-torn neighborhood to being a police officer working in one. I think I've been training my entire career for this challenge.
He now has to implement a 130-page-plus consent decree by the Department of Justice. Its report cleared Officer Wilson, but slammed the Ferguson police for engaging in patterns and practices of racial bias, constitutional violations, and improper ticketing practices that focused on revenue, not public safety.
What are you going to do about that?
Well, that's got to change. You can't tell me that providing tickets for revenue doesn't lead to some sort of corruption. Those things are corrupt at their core because they speak to everything that government is not for. Businesses make profit. Government doesn't. And that's not going to be the practice while I'm here.
And on race, he wants to make sure no one is treated by police like he was as a teenager.
I was called an N-word by a police officer. And then I had another experience where I'm also walking home, a teenager still, and police officer gets out of his car, pushes me up against the wall, he frisks me, and, you know, does his search, then jumps back in his car and he leaves. Now, in both of those experiences, nothing was ever done to restore my dignity. I was embarrassed, I was afraid, and I decided then and there that I needed to become a police officer.
Sara Sidner, CNN, Ferguson, Missouri.